More bounties.
Down you go!
Okay. Another bounty. Find the contract. There we go. This is it. Nope. Wrong direction. I can sell this. Okay, let's take a look around. Come on, come on, come on. No, no. Okay. Can of fuel. Okay. Nothing like scrap.
Hey, booze man. I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not the doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
I think so. I saw something in our approach. I'm going to check it out.
Yeah.
It's probably nothing. Fresh carry, maybe.
Okay, Doc. Lieutenant. Don't become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, even not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
We could be friends now, can't we?
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not the doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry, Lieutenant O'Brien. How long are we going to be here?
What it takes, Corporal. What it takes. I thought I saw something on our approach. I'm
okay, Doc. Lieutenant, don't become carrion yourself.
Only animals can become carrion, Corporal, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Lieutenant O'Brien, field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Demonocitronus or Diptera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I cannot discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrion is indicated. Should be just over here. Damn it, where is it? Speculation as to Demonocitronus is confirmed. Lots of rumors arising around that sooner or later. Carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be Cloudacoibius minus or mule deer. Everybody can check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection from constrained HB.
Well, look at it this way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself. Now, whether that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians, that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes, I am.
How? How are you alive?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, refugee
Nero
camp.
Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb from goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell is you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little spacesuit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead. So I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't, please. You don't... Hey, don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Ryan,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
hell is he alive? They were diverted south. He said that he put her on oxygen. He gave her an IV. He kept her alive. She was septic, so she wasn't gonna make it, but he got her to a mesh unit. He saved her life. He said it. He said he saved her life. She can still be. She. No. But O'Brien is alive. If he is, then maybe.
Deke, you there?
Booze man. A few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay. Deke, you there? Had some time on my hands, made you some shit.
Booze man, thank you, brother. I'll be by. O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. God damn it. You better get back to me, or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on, O'Brien! Get back to me.
Deke, you there? Did you track down the chopper? This is the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night.
Yeah. Yeah, it was him.
Did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
I don't think she's still alive.
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died. I don't need to find any peace. Jesus. I gotta go. All right, Deacon out. Open the gate already.
I know. Let him in.
Thank you. Someone's at the gate.
Hey, let me in.
Hold on, I know him. Open up.
Hey, how's it going out there?
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever. Stop by soon.
See you later. That's all I got.
Hey, man.
Hey, how's it going?
We're gonna run out of this someday, you know. See ya. See you later.
Yeah?
How you doing, kid?
They won't let me leave.
Why would you want to leave? It's safe here.
I have to work.
Okay.
Hey, what do you need?
Just having a look.
Hold on a sec. I'll get it.
Thank you.
They're getting away.
Go after who, Tuck? Slow down.
It's Roach. It's Roach. You know him. He used to ride with Leon and Alvarez. But I trusted him.
Oh, God damn it, Tuck. You shouldn't have.
No. He's taking the rest of our drugs and headed north. My boys lost him somewhere around Marion Forks.
All right. I'll see if I can track it down.
Can't let any of them get out of here alive. A bunch of rapists and murderers. First one down, now the rest of you.
I saw something.
You don't need these.
Who's out there? I saw someone moving out there.
Come on! Charge him! Come on! Come on! Move on him! We got him! killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now?
Open up! We need cover and fire!
Incoming!
Murdering assholes can't let any of them get out of here alive. Finally. Jesus.
I see you hiding.
Here you are.
Ah!
motherfucker!
Something out of this.
Oh no! Freakers!
Last one. Gotta finish this. It's clear. Now you know how it feels, being on the other end of it. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, we look like the type to have an underground bunker. Yeah? There it is, down the hatch.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War, but living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. Man didn't know if his neighbor was an American who bled red, white, and blue, or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him. Taught me the only way to be safe in dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. But we couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods, a ways from the road, where no one would happen upon it. With a bunker, you knew that if the country went to hell in a handbasket, you could open that manhole cover, climb down the ladder, and you'd be safe. With your radio, and your hoard of food and ammo. Things haven't changed. Better to dig a bunker than an early grave. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, Cope? How'd that work out for the poor bastards who owned the one that I just cleared out? Huh? Not so good, I'm guessing. Since they were all dead long before I ever got there.
Deacon St. John, this is Ada Tucker. Alki wanted me to tell you that the camp is thankful for all the runs you've been doing. We need all the help we can get.
That's it.
Open up. Don't get all day.
Open up. I've seen him around.
Except this drifter comes in, pops down a whole string of freaker ears.
How's it going, Deke?
Couldn't believe it.
Hey, Mercer.
Got some ears. Good.
That's it for now.
Stay old, brother. All right?
Two minutes to eat, 10 minutes.
That's all I got today.
See you, Deacon.
How's life as a camper, Alki? Same as ever?
You could use a gun like that. Powerful. Good shot. You'll like this one. Good piece. Should help out in a shit. Here. Good as new. Good choice. That right there, good piece. Come by if you still need something.
What do we got?
Need something?
Need supplies, weapons? All right. I see how it is. I'll see you later, man.
Bet you're here for your bike, right?
How's it going, Zanny?
There you go. Come back soon.